In this video, I'm going to talk about compiling user-defined functions, or UDFs, for Ansys Fluent. So what is a user-defined function? A user-defined function, or a UDF, is a function that you program to enhance the capabilities of Ansys Fluent. For example, you can define a custom velocity inlet profile. They're in C programming language, and there are two ways to get them ready for Fluent. One is using the internal compiler in Fluent, we call them interpreted. And then the other one is using a third-party compiler like Visual Studio or some other C++ or C compilers. And that's when your UDF is compiled for Fluent. Now let's talk about the prerequisites for compiling UDFs. The main thing that you need to have installed on your machine is Microsoft Visual Studio 2008 or later. And you can also use the Express Edition, which you can download for free from Microsoft's website. If you're going to compile your code on a 64-bit computer, just make sure during your installation of Visual Studio, select x64 compilers. All right, let's do a quick demo. First, open Workbench. In this case, I'm using Workbench 14.5, and I have prepared a case file. I'm going to open the file, and I'm going to show you how to set it up for compilation. So here I go in File menu, select Workbench, and once it's loaded, I'm going to show you the mesh. So it's a pretty basic mesh. It's a 2D model of a sphere inside a channel, and basic mesh. At the inlet and outlet locations, we have to create name selections so they come in into Fluent properly, as you can see here. Once you're happy with your mesh, double-click on Setup, and Setup will open Fluent Launcher. And once Fluent Launcher is loaded, the first thing that you have to look at is expand the options and look at Environments tab, and just make sure it is checked to compile the UDFs. So if you have Visual Studio installed on your machine, then you should be able to compile your UDF here. For this model, I'm going to do a transient simulation and select a K-epsilon model, realizable. And the material that I'm using right now, it's air, so we keep it as the default. And in the boundary conditions, I have inlet and outlet conditions. So inlet is an inlet velocity. Right now, the default value is 0. Once we compile the code, we come back here and change this to a variable velocity inlet, for example. So everything else, we keep it as the default. And so let's go and see how we can compile a code. So basically, you have to go define user-defined functions and compiled. And here, the first thing you have to do, you have to add your source code. In this example, I have created a transient velocity inlet. I can show you what we have inside the code. It's pretty basic UDF. Essentially, we start with the header libraries and define a function for defining the velocity profile at the inlet. And this is when velocity at the inlet is exponentially changing with time. So let's go ahead and select this source code. So the source code added to the source section. Next step is to press build. And now Fluent program is going to call Visual Studio C compiler and compile the code and link it and create a library for you. So once you're happy with that, press load. And now your UDF library should be loaded, and it's called inlet profile that we can access it from our boundary condition zones. So in boundary conditions, under velocity, select now, you can see the inlet velocity is actually added to your functions. So here I want to select that as my X velocity component. So Y velocity is 0, but X is going to come from our UDF. So before we run the simulation, let's do a couple of quick things here. Let's just add a quick monitor. And for this one, I'm going to add a area average velocity. And I'm going to look at that velocity at the inlet location. And also, I like to plot it. Since I'm doing a transient run, I like to look at flow time instead of iterations. And press OK here. So we've done with that part. And we can initialize the simulation. Press OK here. and let's go under run calculations, put 1 millisecond for time step and 1,000 iterations. And let's calculate. If I switch to my second window here, here shows that the velocity at the inlet is increasing with time. And that's because it's coming from that UDF that we have compiled and added to the code.